Hi, in this video we're going to learn how to create a supplemental IMF package that contains an alternative picture version. There are some cases that Netflix requires branded and non-branded versions of the picture. The non-branded versions will have an alternative opening credit. Usually the delivery date of the non-branded is much later than the branded, allowing partners to implement all QC fixes into the branded version before creating the non-branded. Otherwise, you will need to create patches to both versions during QC. We don't need to export the entire timeline of the picture to remove the Netflix credit. We just need to trim the desired part of the timeline and export as a supplemental IMF package. This new supplemental will not include the Netflix presentation card. This supplemental IMF package must be created from the last approved IMF package. In this case, that will be the branded package. Let's generate a metadata supplemental IMF package. Let's open our project that we used for our previous IMF packages. Resolve needs the file path of the MXF files from previous IMF packages. Otherwise, the media will be offline. We will use our previous project to create a non-branded supplemental IMF package. If you don't have your project anymore, you should import the previous delivered IMF packages into the media pool to make sure that Resolve knows the file path. If you have questions about these settings, click this link. To create a non-branded supplemental, we must do it from the last successful delivery CPL. In this case, we will use our audio supplemental IMF package. That way, you will have all the patches present in the non-branded version as well. In the media tab, go to the media storage to find the folder with the files we are going to use in our exercise. Here, we are going to use our audio supplemental IMF package. Let's drag our OLB2 under the master bin into the media pool. Now, let's move to the edit page. In the edit page, we are going to create a timeline based from our previous supplemental IMF package. Right-click on the file and select Create New Timeline using Composition Playlist. This will make sure that all the updates that we will make can be saved as a supplemental IMF package. As a name, we will write non-branded underscore supplemental underscore 1 underscore 2020-12-20. Click Create. We just created a new timeline based on our composition playlist. If we make a timeline using the traditional method and then drag the IMF on an empty timeline, it will not work. We will not be able to render a supplemental IMF package. You will always need to select Create New Timeline from composition playlist to create a supplemental IMF package. Otherwise, we will render a complete IMF package instead. Now we are going to remove the Netflix presentation card in our timeline. There are multiple ways to do so in Resolve. In our case, we will use the trim star option, since it is a fast way to do it. First, we will select the trim button in the toolbar at the middle of the interface. Then, we will move our playhead in the timeline next to the last frame of the Netflix presentation card. With our playhead in the correct position, we will go to the trim menu at the top of the interface and select Trim Start. And that's all! We remove the credit and we still have 1 second of black before the start of the picture. And our IMF moves to the beginning of the timeline. We have now created a non-branded version and our timeline should have 1 second of black and silence, the full program, and at the end 1 second of black and silence. Let's move to the deliver page. In the render setting section, we will select the IMF Netflix custom preset. Remember, Netflix does not require a naming convention for IMF packages. However, if you are looking for guidance on folder naming, Netflix provides some optional best practices here. Next to location, click Browse, and we are going to find our folder that we already prepared. In the file name, we are going to press Paste, and we will see the already saved name. This information is unique to each show. Project title, season and episode, picture version, creation date, and CPL-UUIID. The CPL-UUIID is only available after the package was created, so we have to update the folder manually afterwards. Now let's focus on the video tab. We need to make sure to check the supplemental package checkbox. If we don't select this option, the render file will not be supplemental, and Resolve will render the whole timeline as a complete IMF package. All the other settings that are grayed out are part of the Netflix preset, and we cannot change those. Finally, in the composition settings in the content kind drop-down menu, select episode. And that's all we need to do in the project tab. Let's move up and click the audio tab. Here we need to correctly route our audio tracks stereo and 5.1 from our timeline into the IMF. By default, our audio is set to all timeline tracks. We want to manually set this, so we will change the dropdown to timeline track. You will see that this is a 5.1 track, and we are routing timeline track 1 to output track 1. We have to add another track for the 2.0 mix as well. Press the plus icon to create this and set it to timeline track. Make sure that the second timeline track is set to output track 2. You should not change the language code or metadata because we are creating a supplemental package. That's all we need to do to export our non-branded supplemental IMF package. Let's hit add to render queue and in the render queue, start render. Finally, let's check our IMF package. We will do it first inside DaVinci Resolve and then in the Finder. We want to verify the supplemental package in the same project. If we will create a new project, Resolve will not know where the complete IMF package is located. Therefore, the media will be offline. In the project, we are going to move to the media page. And in the media storage, let's search for the folder we created. Inside the folder, we should see just one clip. This is your supplemental IMF package. You can see a small logo that says HDR. This is telling us we have an IMF HDR package. Let's drag our IMF package into the media pool. Here we are going to open the metadata menu and we need to check that the information of the file matches with the setting we create in our IMF. In this case, we can see that our IMF is Dolby Vision UHD and has 8 tracks of audio, exactly as we did. Finally, let's create a timeline with our file. Right-click in the clip and select Create New Timeline Using Composition Playlist. In the name, let's write QC to review and hit Create. If you don't see the option Create New Timeline Using Composition Playlist, will mean that your file is not a valid IMF package. This will create your timeline and a folder that contains the actual MXF synthesis from your previous supplemental packages. Now let's move to the edit page and make sure that everything is correct. We recommend you to do a spot check at the begin, middle, and end of the timeline and verify the changes that you made. After checking the IMF in Resolve, let's open the file in the Finder to quickly review all the different components. This supplemental IMF package does not include any new MXF files, only new metadata. We only changed the endpoint in our timeline, therefore, we did not create any new MXF files. The CPL is referencing the MXF files from our previous deliveries. It is a good practice to compare our non-branded IMF package against the CPL of our previous IMF package before we deliver it. Here you can see that the entry point of our non-branded is different. For more information on the CPL, click this link. Hopefully this video has provided enough information on how to create non-branded supplemental IMF package. If you have questions about how to create video and audio supplementals, you can click on the links in the description.